Hi everyone, I'm Sloan from SloanBella.com and I'm back with another channeled celebrity video. This one, however, has a little bit of a twist with it. I'm channeling someone's energy who isn't actually dead. So technically, I'm not channeling them in spirit, but I am channeling the energy around them and around their energy field and around the situation. Let me explain a little bit. What I'm doing is I'm using a combination of psychic insight and psychic sight. A little bit like remote viewing, but it's a way that I go into meditation to ask for information from those energies around the person because I got such a strong feeling about this person. I've noticed throughout my life, and I call it a little bit of a psychic Tourette's. When I get something in my head and I can't stop saying the person's name or saying what's gonna happen to them or speaking about it, I call it, it's like Tourette's. It's like I have really bad OCD and I can't stop saying their name and I can't stop worrying about them and it keeps popping into my head. What that is that's the other side kind of pinging me on the head saying, pay attention, pay attention, pay attention. So I finally have to speak it. So that's why I'm doing this video. I have to speak it. I need to say it. Before I start with this video, I'm going to explain another focus that I've been hearing a lot on the internet and in print and online and everywhere else about how mediums work. Now, I can only speak from my experience and from those that I know in my personal space and that I have dealt with and worked with for my entire life and professionally for over 30 years. What I'm going to say is that a lot of mediums will tell you that you cannot channel a person whom you don't have a direct connection to. So unless a family member, friend, or acquaintance of the person comes to you and asks about them, you're not going to be able to pick up that person. Now, I wanted to start this a little bit by saying, as a young child, 11 and 12, actually, obviously before that, or maybe it's not obvious, but before that, I used to pick up on those that had passed over in my family, but I didn't know they were in my family because, as I said, I was adopted, so I had no direct knowledge of the people myself. However, technically, they would have been aligned with me on some level because I was living in their family DNA structure by being adopted into that family. But when I was 11 years old and not interested in this person, I'm talking about my friend behind me, where it's right over here, Jimi Hendrix. I used to pick up on Jimi Hendrix. I was not a fan of the music. I didn't listen to the music at the time. To my knowledge, I had no direct connection with this person other than the fact that I was a runaway child. Now, he was partial to street kids and kids that were on the street at the time, and that I can assume is why I was able to pick up on his energy, but I had no knowledge of who he was. I knew him differently than the Jimi Hendrix that was presented publicly, amazing guitarist, amazing talent, but I actually channeled him. I knew he was a musician because he came through that way to me, but I didn't have a direct connection. And here's how I'm gonna word how spirit works from my experience. This is my psychic interpretation and my psychic opinion from doing this work day in and day out. When people tell you you can't do something, it's usually because they want you to focus on them as being the ones who can do it. I believe if a spirit wants to come to you, whether you know that spirit or you don't know that spirit, if they feel like communicating, they're going to find an outlet with which they can be heard. That is how it works. So a lot of times, mediums, young mediums and kid mediums, and I've had many that I've talked to in my life and some in my family, and I've watched them and I've watched the energy they pick up, and they come across it either because they are walking through the energy field or the spirit knows that they're open and receptive to the information. So I don't quite believe that you have to be affiliated with the dead person or connected to one of their loved ones to actually pick up that information. I believe that's not true, at least from my experience, as I say. So all you people wanting to write on the internet different stuff, go for it. As I've said, this has been my experience. I wanted to clear that up because a lot of people ask me that. Now, I'm going right back into the video of the person that I'm channeling. And again, I will say that this person is not dead, they are alive, but it's the information around them. I'm getting the precognitive psychic information about this young woman, and it does cause me concern because I can't put her name out of my mouth. I keep speaking it. So I want to say it so that maybe we can all elevate the energy to help this girl so that she doesn't end up where mediums can channel her from the other side, if you get what I'm saying. All right, so I'm talking about Miss Britney Spears, and we've all known little Britney Spears since she was in the Mickey Mouse Club, coming up all the way to her videos, to her music, and everything about her. We are also acutely aware of what they print in the media about this young woman, who is actually, I believe, 37 or 38 years old right now. What caused me tremendous concern with her on a psychic level is that I can't take her name out of my head, which means for me, the same thing happened for me with Michael Jackson, where I started to get 6-7 months before his passing that he was going to pass, and I started to tell everybody that walked in my space. It means that it's precognitive. It's being set up right now. I'm speaking energetically, not necessarily by anyone trying to kill her. That's not what I mean. It's a precognitive thing, and if I can pick up the strand of energy, the thinking behind it, then it means it's kind of set into motion, because psychic types can't actually do predictive work without it being laid out in front of them energetically. And that's what I believe is happening. Now, what really caused me concern is when I turned the news on, of course, I happened to get in the car. I don't usually listen to the news. There's like one or two things I listen to, but this was a random thing. And it talked about Britney Spears going into court. And what really, really struck me on a psychic core level was they mentioned that she had her bare feet. Now, I'm just going to ask you guys to consider the fact that you've probably been to traffic school. Okay, I put my hand up. I've been to traffic school and traffic court, where I've had to go in, where they search you with all the you know, electrical stuff to see if you have any weapons, what's in your purse, are you carrying drugs in there, you know, do you have a machine gun, whatever it is, because of the way our society is. Now, do you think if I showed up even in traffic court, not a conservatorship court, of my own free will, and I tried to walk in with bare feet, that they wouldn't stop me at the door with the wanding people and the guards that are there and say, excuse me, you need to dress appropriately before you see the judge? Have you ever even been to a court hearing with a convicted murderer, sociopath, homeless person, whoever, where they don't have something on their feet? I found this and my mind went straight. I got two pieces of information from that. One thing is that Britney, the reason she's always photographed in her bare feet had to do with the fact that A, they have conditioned us and we have become used to seeing this young woman in this way. But from her perspective, I picked up really strongly that she's trying to ground herself. So she is connecting to the ground because she feels so ungrounded. I got that right away. The second part of that is, okay, that's her rationale from internally, energetically. But the second part is they want you to see her in bare feet so that you know what's going on. It's a signal of some kind. I was not clear on what that was, but it had two meanings, twofold. The one that I got was that she was grounding herself. I don't know what the other meaning is, but look for it. It's symbolic for some reason. This is what I was getting. The other thing that was of great concern for me is I could hear her crying from the inside out. This woman is trying to get herself back in alignment with Christ, and I got that very strongly. She is not being allowed to do that. So basically, her basic free will and freedom to be who she is being denied her. Now, the next question, which is more of a logical question rather than a psychic question, is who and why would be doing this? Why would this be happening, and who is the one orchestrating this? Well, she's 37 or 38. I think she's probably turning 38 this year. And she is a Sagittarius with an Aquarius moon. Now, that in and itself is an extremely freedom-oriented type of person. They love freedom. Your Sagittarius people, as you know, Sag is out there. We don't know where you go all day. Where do you guys go? They're always running about the neighborhood. They're always on an airplane here, there, and everywhere. It's a great sign, actually, for an entertainer, because they're always on the move. The Aquarius moon is way ahead of its time. It can be very detached. So an Aquarius moon can focus on just what they're doing in the moment, which is exceptionally good, because most of us are emotionally charged and we can't let go of this moment to move on to that moment. Aquarius moon can. So she's very good at her performing in Vegas. If you watch her, apparently it's a really good show. People love it. She makes them billions of dollars, and therein lies the key. My mind was directed to who, why, what, and how. So again, my psychic opinion with this young woman is from a very early age. Now, and this is her energy coming through. It's making me really excited to talk about it. It's like she wants to be heard. This is the energy around her because again, she's not dead, she's on the planet. But I'm picking up on the energy around her. Now let's look at this in just one kind of way. So I was focused on Britney Spears and it was said to me randomly by somebody in the room with me when I was trying to focus on it that I wondered how they would make her stay and perform if she truly didn't want to stay and perform. Because I have tried to make my cat move off the couch and the cat brings out the nails and won't even do it. And that's a cat. I've tried to make little kids do stuff and they just won't do it. So how is Britney Spears stuck in a position that her soul clearly doesn't want to be in? Well, I was having this conversation with myself psychically and somebody walked in the room and said to me something about hypnotism. And I will believe in all things metaphysical, but hypnosis was something that I thought was kind of iffy. I've seen it work and I've had it work on myself. But when you see people in those restaurants back in the day, those shows where you would see the hypnotists and they would hypnotize a whole room full of people and then the people would start taking their clothes off or they would start laughing or they would run from the police that weren't in the room. They could actually make these people do all kinds of things. But they kept stating the fact that we cannot make you do something that you wouldn't normally do. So if they told you to take your clothes off, and you wouldn't be a person that would just randomly take your clothes off in a room, then you wouldn't take your clothes off. So it occurred to me during this conversation, what would happen if they worded it, and this was said to me by the person that walked in on my psychic conversation where I was half speaking out loud to myself. They said to me, what would happen if you told a room full of shyer people that wouldn't rip their clothes off in a room full of people that they had bugs that were biting them inside their clothes and that they needed to get their clothes off to stop the bugs from eating at their skin. Well, 9 out of 10 people, I mean, are gonna just rip their clothes off thinking if there's like little gnats eating their body or little stingers or whatever. Now, what if Britney Spears, with her freedom-oriented mind and her willful personality, was being convinced through hypnotic suggestion and my mind went right into that flow? So I was luckily given the information from an outside source, as in an actual person that came in and told me, brought it up as a hypothetical while I was meditating on it as confirmation. That's how it works for me. Now, can I prove it in a court of law? No, I can't. As I've said, this is my psychic insight. So it's my psychic opinion. But when I was looking at the information with Britney, this is what starts early on in childhood. I flowed right back into her early life and I got a hold of the part of the energy of her that was a young kid and wanting to have fun. The energy I got from Britney and around Britney was as a young child, and I'm talking 2 and 3 and 4 and 5, like a very young kid before you hit preschool, that she was taught very early on how to focus in two different directions. So if you said to kid Britney, focus like this, or you said to kid Britney, focus like this, she was able to distract herself from this to focus on this and vice versa. So something about her mindset was able to move in different directions when needed. And I felt that she was pliable to this as a child. And I also feel that this kind of grooming, and I'm going to use the word grooming because they groomed her from very early on. About the age of 5 onward, she was groomed for this behavior. And I don't actually think that that girl has been in control of her life herself, her entire life. I think everything about her has been focused in the direction of people around her. And what came to my mind, because I was asking them to show me what was going on with her, was basically a form of slavery, energetic slavery. Think of it in terms of this. So we know what slaves are in the world. We have all kinds of information about sex trafficking and slaves, slaves in the South during the 20s, 30s, 40s, 50s, and 60s. We know what slavery is in the traditional sense, but let's take it to a metaphysical and psychic sense. Let's say you have a human being, and this is pertaining to Britney specifically, but let's say you have a human being that's born onto the planet and their energy is creative and fun and childlike and pliable and intellectual and free-form thinking, all of these things. So like a really lovely young spirit that can go in many different directions because they're creative. And let's say on an energetic level, you have energies around the human being that don't have that same structure. They are not creative. They are not born with the ability to feel and to flow through energies in order to be able to create music and art and fun, or even just conversation. And so these energies, and I'm going to call them, for lack of a better word, energy vampires on the other side. They're not in human form. Let's say these things, beings, parasites, barnacles, however you want to word it, but a barnacle is something that catches a ride on a boat. Let's say these are energetic barnacles or vampires that float into the energy field of those around the creatives and try to corrupt what goes on so that they can harness and put into servitude that energy. And that is where I have gone with Britney. That is what has happened to her. Sometimes those barnacles or slave drivers on the other side, vampires, energetic thieves of the human spirit, have a lot of control because they can attach themselves to actual human beings, meaning in our energy field, not actually on us. There are times when they can come into our physical bodies, but they can attach to us. What happens when they attach to us and then we take the creative person and control them? This is what's happening to Britney right now. There is a subversive effort by energetic thieves to steal this woman's essence. I'm wording it that way. When they steal her essence and she no longer complies, like a hostage, they take said hostage. Now read the news, read the newspaper from back in the day with hostages that tried to escape, tried to not comply, slaves that ran away. What happened to them? They were beaten, raped, stripped down. Their families were threatened. Perhaps their children were threatened, and this is where I went with Britney as well. Perhaps her children are her main concern. And if somebody is put into an energetic mindset where their children could be taken from them or harmed, what is a mother, who is truly a mother, going to do with that? They're going to do everything they can to protect their children. And I feel like that's where Britney's mind is. I also feel that Britney, okay, as much as she appears one way, pay attention to the bare feet. It's a marker of what is going on. She is literally trying to ground herself and spiritually fight the vampires. Again, I'm using the word vampires, not in the literal movie sense, but energetically. She is trying to fight that energy by grounding herself, and they have a dual meaning for it. So it is it's dual. There's two ways it can be taken. But I can feel her energy. She's trying to ground herself. She needs people's help at the moment to help her get her strength back, and I'm talking her human strength. She is trying to do that. I see her in prayer. For some reason, they showed me that with her. I can kind of see into where she is. It's how I do it as a form of, I want to call it remote viewing, but I put myself in the place where she is to see what I observe on an energetic level, what I can see going on around her. She is trying to be in prayer, but she isn't doing it outwardly. She's doing it inwardly. Now, what happens when you are in a spiritual war? Because I believe that that's what this woman is in, and I believe it's legitimate. Just like a war on earth can make people disappear, a spiritual war can make you disappear. So what are we looking for with Britney in the coming months? I feel like Britney is getting ready to exit the planet, and that we need to watch what's going on with this woman. Put yourself in this position, even if she is crazy, okay, which I don't believe she's crazy. They may have her drugged. They may have hypnotic suggestion on her. They may be threatening her. I don't know who the theys are, and I'm not making accusations, but people may be doing this to her because there are plenty of homeless people just come to Los Angeles, and not in one case is a family member taking conservatorship over these homeless people that are living and going to the bathroom on the streets, which seems pretty mentally ill to me. Nobody is locking them up. Do you know why? Because they don't have billions of dollars and they're not a cash cow. And I really feel that way. So just in closing, ask yourself why a 37 turning 38 year old woman would, whose father would have conservatorship over her, and why we would allow that as a free country to continue when this woman is struggling on a spiritual level to get her life back, her soul life, not the life she's been living. I'm talking on a soul level, spiritual level. Why do we allow that? Why is nobody speaking up for her? There's a hashtag that says Free Britney, but do these people really understand what's at stake here and why her father would have conservatorship over her money for something like 10 years? And again, look out on the streets in your city, your hometown, but especially in Seattle, in San Francisco, in California, in New York. Look at the homeless people on the street. Look at the crazy antics going on and ask yourself, why aren't they all be dragged into court for conservatorship? They are not. And in fact, if you remember in the 80s when Ronald Reagan was here and he closed down the mental hospitals because he believed in freedom, so he said, we all know it was a money thing, but he said, freedom for the mentally ill, you cannot contain them because they are mentally ill. But yet Britney Spears, because they keep putting her on the news like she's crazy, we think it's okay because we're used to her and we see her. This is wrong. This is wrong energetically. This is wrong as human beings. This is wrong. I don't know why no one's stepping up for her. She's asking for help. And once again, this has been a channeled, non-channeled, energetic, psychic video on celebrity Britney Spears. And my name is Sloan Bella from SloanBella.com.